I want to talk about background color. Here I have the main menu form, and by default Access has set the background color to white. I don't like white as a background color for forms because I want the text boxes to stand out. Text boxes have a white background. I'd like them to stand out from the background. In my opinion, the only reason why you would want to have white as a background color is if you're going to print the form on paper and you don't want to waste ink by printing background color. Okay, so if you actually look at this detail in the properties, you see it says the background color is background 1 and the alternate background color is background 1 darker 5%, right? Because that's not actually white. It's white now, but it can change depending on what your Windows color scheme is, right? So for example, here's my wallpaper, and if I go to personalize, see at the bottom where it says a window color, right? I could change my window color to dark green, right? And I could make it darker, right? And then see under advanced settings, right? I could set the color of anything to anything, right? Like I could click on active title bar and I say I want my active title bar to be black. Right, that would not be such a good idea because it makes it hard to read the text. Right, let's change it to blue. Okay, even that's not great, but it's possible I could do that. Right, I could make it green. That's ugly, but I'm doing this for testing purposes. Right, then I could make the font blue. Right. And see the alternative color, that's the color on the right. I could make the alternative color red. Let's make it really ugly just for testing purposes. Right? I could make the message text blue, right? Then the text background I could make yellow, right? And the text color I could make red, right? And any other item, right? Message box, okay, message box. Font, dark green, right? Inactive window, black, right? And the font could be gray, right? And the alternate color, well, let's leave that as white, right? Desktop, let's make it dark blue, right? So I'll save these changes here. See how ugly everything looks. Right. Then if I go to my form, let's close the database and let's open it again. Right, and you see that now my main menu is yellow, right? That's because the it's set according to the Windows colors, right? And because the window, it's really set to background 1, right? Which is what I just set to the bright yellow there, right? So it might be that you want to do this, right? There are some people that are visually impaired, so they use the visually impaired color scheme, which is really like really bright colors that stand out. So it's possible you might want to do that, but you should be aware that background 1 is not white. Like, it might look white, but it might vary from computer to computer depending on what the user's color scheme is. So I prefer to set the color explicitly, right? Like, not to use any of these, because any of these will vary according to what the user's color scheme is on their PC, right? So that's why I prefer not to use any of these. Also, it can cause a problem because some users will accidentally set their background color to black, and then they'll set their text color to black also, and that means they can't read their text, right? So I prefer to go here, click on the ellipsis, right, and set the color explicitly. Light blue is kind of a nice color for background color, so I'll use that, right? And alternate background color means if you have two forms, right, then they're different colors. I actually don't like that. I like to set them to the same value. So let me set them to the same value here. I accidentally clicked on theme colors. I don't want theme colors, I want standard colors right here on the bottom. Let me choose a dark blue 3 here. And then let me choose dark blue 3 here again, right? So that if you have two forms, they will both be dark blue 3, right? So that way you have this will be dark blue 3 no matter what Windows color scheme on what PC you have, right? And suppose you have a heading here, right? Let me just put a heading on here. Label like this. English space dog, or whatever the name of your company is, right? So then if this was a real company, you would make the font something that stands out, such as Arial Black, right? And you would make the font bigger, right? Okay, but notice the color. That green is probably not a good color, right? And you don't know what Windows color scheme the user has, right? So it might be like dark blue or dark blue text, right? Which would be impossible to read against a dark blue background. So let's set the value of the text, right? That's called the for color, right? See, right now it's set to text 1, lighter 50%. Well, I'll hit the ellipsis here, right? And I'll choose a standard color, right? And you don't have to choose a color from this box. You can define your own color, right? If you click under more colors here, you can specify color by clicking on the palette here, right? So like if I click on the purple here, then the text will be purple, right? But I can also specify a color according to the RGB value, right? You also have your recent colors here, the colors that you've recently used, right? So if you wanted it to be the same, like if I wanted it to be the same as the background, right, then I could do that. But I don't. So I can also set the RGB value. That's the red, green, blue value. And each one of these numbers is a number from 1 to 255. 255 is the maximum value, right? So if I wanted it to be maximum red, I could do that, right? Then if I wanted it to be maximum green, I could do that, right? And if I wanted no blue whatsoever, I could say 0, right? And that'll give you yellow, right? Because in the primary color scheme, red plus green equals yellow. But suppose you don't want any green whatsoever, right? Then you would do that, then it's pure red, right? Or if you wanted half green, then you put in 128, right? And that gives you kind of a beigey color. Well, that's kind of a nice color, so let's try that. Not perfect, but this is just an example anyways. Right. So that's how you set your colors.